Please rise.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. Oh, dwell in dark and sin, my hand will stay. I obey.
As we said in the beginning of Mass, our faith is in Jesus, and the bottom line is that our Lord has said to us, there's another life, and we rest our case with that. The first reading is taken from a letter of St. Paul. St. Paul was a great follower of our Lord. And he made many converts, brought many people to our Lord. But this part of his letter is, he's at the end of his life. And what he writes, and we share today, is the bottom line. And the bottom line is, we have a new life waiting for us. So St. Paul wrote, as he was dying, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there awaits for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord God shall give to me, and for those who have kept the faith in Christ. The prayers of all.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing. pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall.
Cheerful and he had a lot of ailments. And with his scooter, he would go in and out. God help you if you were in his way. And he was cheerful. Well, like all of us had a bad day and so on. But when you met him, I'd say, Joe, how are you doing? Good, considering all things. He was a nice guy. And I think that's one of the best compliments we can give him. He was a nice guy. We are living in a world today, you and I know, that isn't so nice. Due to the virus that struck us for 14 months, it has hardened some of us, have made us angry, unpleasant. And today, to be kind is unusual. But Joe was that. He'd come down to the dining room as we had dinner a number of times, with Jerry, of course. And he was always cheerful. It was a time that I looked forward to having dinner with him. Now, I don't know about you, there were some people that you don't want to have dinner with. They're miserable people. And you get ulcers eating with them. But we can't say that was Joe. Joe was always, he would always ask, how are you doing? He would reach out. And we know people who never ask you how you're doing. If you ask them how they were doing, they'd give you a long song and dance. But Joe was not that. And he was a great asset to our community. Those that know our community, it's a small community. It's a small family, and we interact with one another, and what affects one member affects the others, and if you're not a pleasant person, it doesn't really help us. As I said before, there are people, even where we live, that you say, oh dear Jesus. Not today. Give me a break. But, my friends, Joe leaves great memories for us who had the pleasure to be with him, with Jerry, and touched our lives all the time. So I'm blessed for having known Joe and that he was in my life. And we know, as we said before, not easy to lose somebody that we love. But we know he's in another world. And one day, it'll be our time to be there. And so today we say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for Joe's life that touched our lives. He was the salt. As we all know, when we put salt on our food, it gives it a great taste. And he was the light. He wasn't a person of darkness. So he did what our Lord said. Be the salt, be the light. And Joe did that. Amen.
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 Make me a channel of your peace with
Diocese, and for all the clergy. And Lord, we offer this Mass for Joe, a faithful servant of yours. Remember all our brothers and sisters, all who fall asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of you today, as we pray with our Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Saint Joseph, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages. We may merit to be called co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
will do the final for us. Lord, into your hands we commend Joe. We are confident that all who have died in you shall be raised to life on the last day and shall live with you forever. We thank you today for the blessings that came into his life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship of our Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome Joseph to paradise. Help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until one day we meet him in heaven. We always say it is the name of Jesus, who lives forever and ever.
Amen.
May our Lord bless Joseph. May he bless all of us who are his members. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you, my friends, for sharing today.
Let's speak to God.
Hold you in the palm of his hand.